Hi everyone, I'm Nunz, Nunz number one. Anyway, I'm from Bearcage, we're Canberra's largest TV and video production company. So our history's been one pretty much of a constant sort of innovative one. And the only thing we've ever done to grow is to innovate what we do and how we do it. So I'm one of the three partners. We've been all Canberra born and bred, and we've worked together for the last 20 years in the creative industry. Our business works broadly with clients of government, corporate and TV. All of those clients have basically the one need, and that's a story to tell. Fortunately, we're in the business of telling those stories. And of course, all of those stories start with an idea. So our job is to turn that idea into a reality. So what I want to talk about today is how we turn, sort of how we've innovated our approach to turning stories into reality. So what we thought about, the three of us, about what was really important to us in our business, we realised that the most important thing was you guys, the audience. We wanted our stories to be able to engage and connect with the stories that we tell. So we sort of embedded that thought into our corporate philosophy, which is to connect with people by creating experiences for audiences. And we try to embed that in our DNA so that everyone who works for us really understands that that's what they're there to do. And it's worked really well. What that's done is build a high-performance creative culture with a focus of transitioning people from artists to artisans. It's made our creative process reliable and repeatable. So how do we do it? This is how we do it. We really understand and we embrace that the fact that creativity loves boundaries. It's key in how we turn our ideas into anything real. Without this, we just have lots of ideas and we find it very hard to bring them back to reality. TV is a special animal because we all watch a heap of TV. We all know what TV is. We understand what we like, what we don't like. We're very visually literate. What we don't understand so well is what other people might like and how we might conceive our ideas for an audience that's not you. So, what do we do about it? We talk to creative people who think it's TV, we can do whatever we like. So there's a lot of blue sky thinking about, well, we can, you know, fly to Peru and do all this kind of stuff. Again, often it's the fairies trying to get creatives back down to Earth to work out a way of actually making a show that someone might want to watch. So like any good business, when you're faced with a problem, what did we do? We restructured and resourced ourselves to tackle the problem. So in our case, it meant put a new person in who is sort of tasked with wrangling with creatives and regulating our kind of ideas factory. Now, one of the roles that she has is to convene this weekly meeting that everyone in the company comes to, and we just talk about TV ideas, and you bring your idea to the table. But if you bring an idea, you need to meet three criteria. One, the audience. Who's going to watch it? You? Grandmother, who's it for? Two, what's the budget? How much will it actually cost to make this kind of TV? Is it $1 million? Is it $40,000? You need a real figure. And thirdly, is it really a show we can make? Is it the sort of thing we can do? Then the numbers come in. This is our ratio, 10 to 1. Every month there are 10 ideas that meet that criteria. We've got to pick one. One of those ideas goes forward and becomes our idea that we'll take to market. So, how do we choose the right one out of those 10? Well, a good example that we're working on at the moment that will be on air on the ABC in about 2 weeks is a show called The Boffin, The Builder and The Bombardier. So it'll be on, it's an 8-part series about historical myths versus scientific fact. So Mythbusters meets the History Channel. So we have a guy who's the Boffin and he digs up sort of these historical challenges. The Builder, who basically builds what was in the history books, and the Bombardier, who basically blows it up. So that meets our sort of three criteria quite well, because we know that kind of Mythbusters style show of guys getting together and making things has a wide demographic, especially with men and boys. There's kind of a lot of funding for shows like that, but the rates of the ABC, Screen Australia will pay for stuff like that. And most importantly, we have the Boffin, the Builder and the Bombardier, three actors who really embody the spirit of the show, which brings us back to the reason we make shows. Full circle, back to the audience. So in the TV world, the audience equals the buyer. So in our model, we don't develop ideas and bring ideas forward that we don't know are positioned to go to somewhere like the ABC or SBS or Foxtel. So hopefully from this, I want you to take away the idea that any of these ideas that tend to really only start with you. So if you've got a philosophy and a thing that you believe in, bring that into your organisation, get into your DNA, and importantly, systemise and codify it if you can, as much as you can. And often we hear, you know, creative companies restricting and limiting things is kind of the opposite of what creative companies are supposed to do. But for us, it's been a really effective way of kind of understanding the creative process, demystifying it, and making actually money and great shows out of it. So thanks, everyone.